Oh, live massages happening upstairs here at Fox and Channel 2.
I think it's weird that our bosses have a National Massage Day. It's nice, don't get me wrong.
I think it's nice.
Free massages to every employee of Channel 2 or Fox, and that's Dave, our engineer. No one's monitoring our tower right now or our signal because Dave's getting a wonderful back rub.
What if we have an emergency?
Well, don't tell Dave. He's asleep. By the way, later in the show, we're going to sneak up there and replace the massage therapists, and we're going to do it.
See if they notice a difference.
I think they will. Okay, here's the deal. It is a big week for Denver. Hollywood coming to the Mile High. The Starz Denver Film Fest is going to kick off tomorrow night. The red carpet opening features the premiere of Rabbit Hole. Director John Cameron Mitchell, actor Aaron Eckhart will both walk the red carpet, and they'll speak after the film. It goes down tomorrow night at the L.A. Culkin's Opera House, 7 p.m. Big red carpet. How about this? We would like to send you to that red carpet premiere on us. We have tickets to both the red carpet movie and to the party, opening night party afterward at the Sewell Ballroom down there. This is swanky. This is awesome. Are you excited, Natalie?
Yeah.
All you got to do is go to our Facebook page right now, Colorado's Everyday Show. Tell us about what film you want to see or about the film fest, and we'll give away those tickets to tomorrow's red carpet. It's the hottest ticket in Denver. Mm-hmm. The hottest ticket in town. We got it. You know, Natalie was on a reality show a couple of years back. It was called So You Think You Can Shave. Remember that?
I failed miserably.
Yeah. The more popular show, of course, is So You Think You Can Dance. And guess what? Those dancers heading to Colorado tonight. The top seven from this season of SYTYCB will be shaking their groove thang at the First Bank Center in Broomfield. The show starts at 7:30. Tickets are still available.
Hmm.
That'd be fun. And look, there's Natalie's giant high heel in the back. There you go. Let's head out to Hollywood as we do every day. TMZ.com, my favorite website. Dax, my favorite Hollywood dude. And Dax, I understand we have an arrest to report today. Is that true?
Well, not really an arrest, but someone got cited and got a ticket.
What happened?
Barry Bonds. Are you talking about Barry Bonds?
I am, yes.
Yes. So basically, he got pulled over in West Hollywood last night. The cops gave him a little ticket. He was driving around talking on his cell phone, which is a huge no-no out here in California. He was given his $125 fine and then let go on his merry way. It just kind of seems fitting after, you know, the World Series and everything that happened last night.
Wow. Maybe more importantly, what was he doing in West Hollywood? Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Just asking. No answer from Dax.
No.
Dax no longer even bothers to answer my questions. He is so over
giving
me.
Giving up.
Yeah. Dax, you know I follow all the teen idols. I love the Joe Bros. And, you know, Demi Lovato has been touring with them. But she's in a kind of a serious way. What do we know about her entering rehab?
Yeah, she dropped out of touring around with the Jonas Brothers to check herself into a treatment center for physical and emotional issues. And it seems like we've gotten some more information that we just posted. It basically stems back to being bullied most of her life. A lot of kids, I guess, had taken shots at her throughout her childhood, and it led to self-destructive behavior. And so a catalyst a couple weeks ago or recently was that she got into a physical altercation with a female member on the tour and then decided, you know what, I need to go seek some help for this. And so she has now checked herself in, and I guess we're going to keep our fingers crossed that she gets some help. I mean, she's 18 years old, you know,
poor kid.
So hopefully she gets healthy.
Yeah, absolutely. Our thoughts are with her for speedy recovery. And maybe finally, Dax, you know, it's election day, and I'm curious, being the major stoner that you are you going to vote for the marijuana law there in California?
Major stoner? What are you talking about?
I've heard
You're
stories.
Crazy.
I'm just saying. So you don't have to tell us, Dax. I think we all know how you'll be voting on that proposition.
Oh, shut up.
Shut up. You got to shut up.
Dax and I are like brothers.
Way to go, Dax.
We'll see you tomorrow, my friend. Dax, our Castle Rock
cutie. Guys.
The guy grew up right down the road in Castle Rock, and now he's making it big in Hollywood.
It's a wholesome Colorado kid.
Even if he does smoke once in a while.
Okay, look. You know, I've said this many times. It is not easy being Slytherin. The new Harry Potter film comes out this month, and the actor who plays Malfoy says he was bullied his entire childhood because of the film. Mm. Tom Felton says his jealous classmates called him names, picked on him. He says Harry Potter robbed him of his childhood. I know how it feels. You know why I know? Because I am being picked on now as the 40-year-old over-the-hill Harry Potter.
Grab your wand. We're flying you for free to the exclusive Harry Potter exhibit in Seattle, where you'll also be the first to see the Deathly Hallows. Watch and win all week, only on Every Day.
People are telling me I look like Katie Lang. Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, it's humiliating. So the hair's not, or Paul McCartney from the early days. But look, I made that announcement for good reason, because guess what, my friends? It is time for day one of our big Harry Potter contest. We want to send you and a guest to the Harry Potter exhibition in Seattle. We'll fly you out there. We'll put you up in a swanky hotel. You'll get to see all the props and costumes from the film. And then we give you and your friend free tickets to the advanced screening premiere in Seattle.
Nice.
All you gotta do is know the code word of the day. And today's code word is...
Do I get to say it?
Go for it.
Potter.
What is today's code word?
The code word is Potter.
Say it like
Potter.
Potter.
Yeah.
So,
Potter.
What you do is go to our website, kwgn.com/everyday, enter code word...
Potter.
And you are entered for a chance to win. And by the way, every day is a different code word, so you can enter multiple times and increase your odds of winning the more you watch.
Can you enter more than once a day, or
once
each
a day.
Day with the code word?
Once a day, once per code word. So good luck. Enter that word.
Potter.
Potter. Potter. Last week, we showed you those racy photos from the kids of Glee. And turns out, all eyes are on those show choir hotties. The GQ magazine spread, remember this one?
Yeah.
It's gone big time.
Yeah.
They've had 33 million hits on their website. Normally, they get 2 million. So something about this photo has the guys clicking to their website. I wonder why.
What could it be?
What could it be?
Hmm.
33 million hits. By the way, that issue is now out on newsstands. We all know that Snooki loves the tanning bed. In fact, she's so into it, she is even fake baking her nuts.
Snooki does it with UV rays.
You like that? Snooki has put down the pickle and has picked up the pistachios. The pint-sized Guidette is now the official spokesperson for the Pistachios Get Crackin' campaign.
Snooki does it.
Wow.
There you go.
Get Crackin'.
Get Crackin', Snooki.
Woo!